For centuries, humankind lived in balance with nature. Over the years, our population, as well as our needs, have expanded. In the process, we have altered the Earth's entire surface and exploited large amounts of its scarce resources. One of the biggest issues confronting our world today is the impact that we, as human beings, have on the planet. From environmental pollution to climate change, human-made activities, such as long-distance traveling, are threatening the Earth's delicate ecosystems and its inhabitants. It is time we ask ourselves, how do we create a future in which both people and nature can thrive? How do we achieve a sustainable existence on Earth while still fulfilling our personal needs? Right now, the world is in desperate need of new technologies. It is up to us to do something unprecedented to change the future. Join us in changing the future of mobility.
One of the major issues that we see in transport currently is basically air travel. In 2019, 4.5 billion people have traveled with airplanes. And these numbers have risen throughout the years. This is a huge problem because airplanes are one of the most polluting means of transport. And this is something that we wanted to change with the Hyperloop concept. So the Hyperloop is essentially a train that levitates through a partly evacuated tube close to supersonic speeds. And this system enables very high velocities and at the same time a very good energy efficiency because there is basically a very low air pressure and therefore no air resistance or very low air resistance and almost no rolling resistance due to the levitation of this train. We've seen maglev trains all over in Asia, for example, but also in Germany back in the 1970s. And this is basically what we're trying to revive here, but with a tube around it with no air inside.
The first idea for vacuum transport was in the early 20th century. And then Elon Musk motivated and introduced this concept again with the wording Hyperloop in 2013 with a white paper.
The Hyperloop concept combines the advantages of air travel and train travel. It's as fast as an airplane, but as energy efficient as a train. And this makes the whole concept sustainable and energy efficient.
Yeah, and of course you need energy, but when you combine the Hyperloop system with some solar cells, we have a really environmental friendly system.
So essentially, the Hyperloop is an end-to-end connection intracontinentally between very big cities in Europe. So you could travel, for example, from Paris to Berlin in just half an hour. And this is amazing about the technology.
Misuro Hyperloop wants to focus on two different domains. On the one hand, that's the research on Hyperloop systems. On the other hand, we are engineering a whole prototype for a Hyperloop capsule that includes the electronics, the mechanics, but also the propulsion systems.
It's also very important to take into account there's lots of other things around that have to be done. For example, the marketing, the whole HR topics, and also the management and the project plan have to be done.
We are a team of almost 60 students working on cutting-edge technology to shape the future of mobility.
We have a very skilled and a very motivated team, but of course, we rely on very important partners, and we are so pleased to have lots of very skilled and lots of very motivated teams and professional partners around us. And they are supporting us with knowledge, with money, with funding.
One example is that we're working right now here at the Zeiss Innovation Hub at KIT, and we're very proud and pleased to be able to do our everyday work here. What makes this endeavor so highly interactive is the exchange of ideas and experiences with other student teams all over the world. The ultimate goal for us is then to participate in the European Hyperloop Week in Valencia this year as the only German team.
The cost of a Hyperloop infrastructure will be very high. For this reason, we want to collaborate with locals, politicians, and also construction companies to figure some solutions out and to build a full-scale prototype and a full-scale concept in the future.
We are pretty sure that Hyperloop will see implementation throughout the next decades because it closes a gap that is fundamentally right now. I'm pretty sure that by the year of 2035, we will see a real implementation of the Hyperloop system.